We're all feeling the pinch of the high cost of living, and heating homes during the cooler months is only adding to the bills. So we're turning to an expert in energy saving to help us understand how we can better manage our homes and save some extra money in the process. Andy Logue, Director of Energy NZ, joins us from a very special house. And Andy, you're going to give us a bit of a tour this morning. Morena, how are you?
Well, yeah, very good, thank you. I wouldn't say too special. disclaimer here, do as I say, don't do as I do.
Brilliant.
I can show you some bad things about my house. So,
Andy, we so appreciate you doing this for us, because I think we're all going to learn a lot from you this morning. Before you actually take us on a tour and give us some tips in terms of how we can save money on our power bills, just talk to me about Energy NZ and what it is that you guys actually do in the first instance.
Yeah, so this is a little bit unique, I guess, this morning, talking about residential power. So we're typically working with the large energy users around the country. So you've probably heard a lot on the news around decarbonisation, challenges we face around that at the moment. So that's a big part of what we do. So, you know, we're talking with some organisations that are spending up to $1 million a year on energy, or even $1 million a month, some of them. Yeah, much larger than what we're talking about today. But look, the principles are all the same.
So, all right, Andy, let's talk about... and again, thank you so much. This is very generous of you to do this in your own home. But talk to us about how we can keep our homes warm and dry.
Yeah, so... Look, the first thing I'd just say is that, you know, there is ways to actually reduce how much you're paying for electricity. So... There was a marketing campaign started about at least sort of 10 years ago now, What's My Number? So if you Google that, there's a website, PowerSwitch, and that just enables people to go in, do a quick cost comparison between their incumbent electricity retailer and maybe someone that might be cheaper. So just, a word of warning there, I'll just say... these guys want to be your... they want you to be their customer, not their friend. So just be careful of these little giveaways for TVs and $200 of free power. So that's a really good... that's something that people can have a look at doing.
Yeah, but actually, Andy, sorry, before you move on from that, is that something that you would recommend people to do, but just be wary of what you've actually just spoken about?
Yeah, well, first of all, what you'll find with a lot of those deals and the bundle deals as well, you'll have often a two-year supply contract. So it just means that if you do find a cheaper retailer, you're going to get
locked in.
Fee of maybe $150, $200 to break that contract. So just be wary of that. So that's the first thing I'd say. Look, in terms of some other things, just some while we're in the kitchen here, energy efficiency wise. You'll see these days, I mean, everything has this big as ugly sticker on there. It's there for a reason. Has this Energy Star rating on there. Tells you how much energy that your appliance is going to use. So anyone that's out there shopping for new appliances, we've all got smartphones. It's a pretty simple calculation. You don't need school C maths to work out how much energy or how much this is going to cost you to run. But do it over a 10-year period and just compare it with something that... that might be a cheaper appliance, and you might be surprised that over 10 years you're going to pay double what you would in energy as opposed to having a more efficient one. So I thought I'd take you around and have a look at my house. Now we've just had our floors redone, and we don't actually have any blinds up at the moment, and that is not something that I'm telling people to do. So really, in terms of trying to keep your house warm, the big tip there is you're trying to keep the heat in, not let the cold out. The other thing too is just trying to maximise that sun during the day when it's not raining in Auckland, and get plenty of ventilation through there. So it's much easier to heat a dry home than it is a colder home. And one of the things that I've done, which probably has had the biggest impact, is putting in a home ventilation system. So much harder for people that don't have a roof cavity, but if you can, it's certainly something I'd advise people to do.
Andy, what about the different times in terms of when to open and close? I mean, obviously you've got no blinds, as you've just said, but when to open and close your blinds and how that can actually help?
Yeah, so, I mean, certainly, the general rule of thumb is in the morning we generally get up, we go to work, so we're that's going to be the trigger to open the blinds. But it's really, it's that evening time. So I would sort of suggest that around that, it's that 5:30 p.m. Mm. depending on when the sun is kind of setting. But that's ideally, you know, what you want to be doing in terms of closing those blinds. So that's probably the key one is just when to start closing them. So you want to do that before it starts getting dark. Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Nice. Thanks, Andy.
So so we've got the, I'm cooking everyone at home today because I've got the heat pump going just so we can see where heat has been lost through the house. So I've got a thermal imaging camera here and we're going to come over here to the these doors, these big glass doors. And yeah, hopefully you can see, well, I'll show you, we've got the heat
so
pump
what is
up
it,
here.
So what's that actually away. Showing us, Andy?
So where you've got the darker areas here is where it's essentially where it's the surface is very cold,
and okay. you can see. So you're talking about that pink. Well, it looks pink on our screen, pink, blue.
Oh, okay. The dark, whatever the darker, yeah. Yep. The pink, purple, kind of darker blue type colour that you can see on there. So that's just having a look at the glass and just how much heat has been lost there. But we've also look down the bottom there as well, where we've got a little bit of an air gap. And that's basically where there's air infiltration coming in. So that's also having a bit of an impact as well. And then we've got another door over here.
The old door stoppers, the old snakes, throwing a couple of those down the bottom.
Even a towel.
Yep. Yeah.
Exactly. Yep. So even a towel. And as I said, a disclaimer at the start, I'd actually taken those. You can get the small little, almost like a little broom across the door. And we've had those with the little bristles on there. So that's what we've had fitted on there. But we've just had the floors redone. But look, the other thing too is that in terms of heating your home, it's very expensive to start putting in heat pumps. But there is a lot of support around for lower income households. So this stuff doesn't have to be outside of your reach in terms of insulation and heating. So there's a website it's on the ECA website, Warmer Kiwi Homes. Kiwi Warmer Homes, Warmer Kiwi Homes, doesn't matter if you get it around the wrong way, if you're dyslexic, you'll find the website. And so on there, depending on where you live in the country, and whether you have a community services card, you can actually get up to 80% funding for home insulation, as well as another 80% for a heat pump or a wood type burner. So there's, there is a lot of support around for the lower income people to keep their house warm.
Yeah, I've just jumped on that website and actually it's quite easy to negotiate. So as you say, it doesn't matter which way around, you put that in, Warmer Kiwi Homes, it'll come up and it's got the information around subsidies. Andy, I'm just wondering about, in terms of power saving, appliances and when we should be turning off appliances at the wall, because many of us are guilty of just keeping everything on. Is there anything in that in terms of turning off your appliances at the wall, or some at least?
Yeah, and I think a real easy, and we can actually have a look at that again. So again, here's an example over here. Sorry, you might not be able to see there. So the AV cabinet, which a lot of people have, you can probably see this time we're looking at the stuff that's hot. And there's a couple of set boxes and stuff in there. And so, you know, the one thing I'd say is wherever you've got heat, you've got energy. So you can generally go around and feel those appliances. If you don't have a thermal imaging camera, a cat's usually pretty good at finding warm spots. So these are you'll be quite surprised at just how much energy these things will use. It might be quite small on an individual basis, but these days we've got so many different set boxes, microwaves, even the washing machine, can still, the screen, etc., can still be on. And towel rails is another one as well. So it's just that it's not, these things aren't visibly using energy, and that's what makes it a little bit difficult. So another really good tip for people is that you now have, literally every house now has a smart meter. So that means through your energy retailer most of the time, you can actually look at how much house, how much energy your house is using overnight. So when everyone's in bed, how much power are we using? And you might be surprised. And and I'll put my hand up and say, you know, I was quite surprised as well. And then, I found that there was something that was turned on at midnight at night, which were some just heated tail rails. So, you know, we had just having a look over the Christmas period, and you're still using that's, you know, if you're away for a week or so, just have a look at how much energy your house is still using, and you might be surprised, because that's basically what it is.
Andy, I cannot thank you enough for your generosity this morning, not only for the information and tips that you're giving us, but actually allowing us into your home to show us the different things where we can save money and look at our heating in our home. Andy, thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Hey,
quickly, website where we can check out any of these kind of hints?
We can put that on our website in the next couple of days, if you like, because it's a little bit disjointed in terms of where all this information lies. So that's just energynz.com, nice and easy.
Nice.
And we'll put a bit of summary on there today.
Love it. Thanks so much again, Andy Logue from Energy NZ Director.